Welkom, Revelation 7, de 144.000 Sealed Ones of Israel. Chapter 7 start with, after this I saw four angels standing at the four corners of the earth, which we encountered also in Zechariah 6. There we encounter also the red, black, white and dappled horses, but there they are in plural. They crosses the earth, but the explanation of their job is given here in Revelation. They have the power to harm the earth and the sea, but they are restricted that first the servants of God must be sealed. Who need to be sealed? Well, the 144.000 sealed ones of Israel. 12.000 out of every tribe of Israel. But notice that the tribe of Dan is not present and is replaced by the tribe Manasseh, the first son of Joseph. They say that Dan is excluded because of his intercourse with Bilhah, his stepmother's maid, and his father's concubine. Others say that out of the tribe of Dan rises the Antichrist. I don't believe that. So, which are the tribes? They are described in the verses 5 to 8. It also means that the 10 tribes, which we don't know at the moment where they are, the 2 tribes of Judah, the Jews are living in Israel, but where are the other 10 tribes on earth? We don't know, but it will be clearly because at that time they will be sealed. It is like the blood which was strewn on the doorpost when the Israelites were leaving Israel. They needed to strike the blood of the slaughtered lamb on the doorpost so that the angel of death would pass and not kill their firstborn. So they were in a way sealed as well by the blood of the lamb. So whether it will be a physical sign visible to persons that they are the sealed ones, that they are protected by this seal, that the beast and all the other bad persons on earth are not able to do any harm to them, we don't know. The Bible doesn't state it here, or that they are invisible sealed, like the believer has the Holy Spirit. The believer is sealed by the Holy Spirit, but the believer who lives under the control of the Holy Spirit, they experience the force of the Holy Spirit. So it might be that as well that those Sylvans experience the force of God proclaiming the kingdom of God. So what will those 144,000 proclaim? Well, they clearly will not proclaim the gospel. The church is taken up into heaven, so they will proclaim the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God they will proclaim. The wise, the true believers, the wise virgins, they have been taken up into heaven. So what is proclaimed here is the repentance over sin, the acknowledgement to be a sinner, that they need God, that they are not capable to liberate themselves from sin and accept God the Father and refuse the mark 666 of the beast, would probably means that they will be martyred and be slaughtered, get death penalty, they will die, but they will get eternal life on the new earth. Well, who are the great multitude who no man could number? I think it refers back to the chapter 4 of Revelation with the 24 elders and the 4 living creatures. There were in chapter 4 standing before the Lamb. So clearly we are in heaven or not. I will come back to that later. And they all together are worshipping God. But now it comes to a problem in verse 13 with the question, who are those clothed in white robe and whence have they come? And the answer is, they have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. So, we are sifting a great time. Well, I think we do, because chapter 6 ended with the final of the great tribulation. And chapter 7 verse 1 started after this. So after the end of chapter 6, the end was described of the final of the great tribulation after this. So the great tribulation has finished and we are entering now in chapter 7. So the ones which has washed their robes white in the blood of the Lamb, we are talking about here, this great multitude, they are resurrected from the death they encountered in the great tribulation, and now they are worshipping God at the end of the great tribulation. But we are talking about the blood of the Lamb. Yes, we are. We are not talking about the gospel. No, Jesus Christ died for their sins as well. They are resurrected from the death. They are encountered in the great tribulation. So also for them is the blood of the Lamb. In the great tribulation there will be the preaching of the kingdom of God. So let's go to Mark 1, the verses 1 to 5. The beginning of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, Behold, I send my messenger before thy face, who shall prepare thy way. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. John the baptizer appeared in the wilderness, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sin. That's the preaching of God in the great tribulation. Repentance for the forgiveness of sins. That's what is the preaching of the kingdom of God. The repentance of sins. And who gives the forgiveness of sin? Only through the blood of the Lamb, the Messiah, Jesus. Let's go back to Revelation, verse 17. They served him, the Lamb, Jesus Christ, in his temple. For the Lamb in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd. And he will guide them to springs of living water. Springs of living water. Let's go to chapter 22. The springs of living water flows out the new Jerusalem on the new earth. So clearly we are at the end of the great tribulation, or we are on the new earth. So that we conclude that the verses 9 to 17 are at the end of the great tribulation, or at the end of the millennium. That's chapter 7. I hope it helps you in understanding, and please tell your friends that this is the order of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1 and 3, proclaim this prophecy. So, we are living in the final times. It is our job to proclaim Revelation, to make known and explain Revelation to the world. Believers and unbelievers. So let's do our job and proclaim Revelation. Thank you.